equation. How would we apply that concept to this equation? We have a quantity we're not aware of, we don't know it, plus 9 is going to be the same as having 73. Get it?
You just take 9 away from 73, subtract 9 from 73.
Just take 9 away from 73.
And you get your answer 64.
Well, so far, what I've done says x plus 9 equals 64.
No.
Okay. And I know, Jaden, your paper doesn't say x plus 9 equals 64, right? It says x equals 64.
Yeah.
But it's important. Everyone, eyes up here. Quiet, please. James, Matt, Hunter, everybody. So we need to do the same thing to both sides, not because it's like doing it wrong or doing it the way that I don't want you to do it. It's because to show each step, to show our work, is what's going to make it easier in the future when there's more stuff going on. It's more complicated. So when we subtract 9, the reason we subtract 9 is because there's this 9 added on to the x. And what's 9 minus 9?
0.
There's 0. So what we have is x plus 0. What's x plus 0?
It's
just x. If we add 0 to x, we just have x. And on the other side, we'll take 9 from that as well, and we're at 64. So that must be what x is. Because this amount minus 9 is just x. So this amount minus 9 must be equivalent to x. It started balanced, we made sure it stayed balanced, so x is 64. Try this. Let's try this. I'll subtract 7. 11 minus 7.
No.
That's 4.
Okay, and then this says x equals 4. Now, rather than telling me what I should do, I want you to tell me why this can't be the right answer. Like, explain it in very clear, logical, mathematical terms.
It is like the last equation. You have to turn from plus to negative.
But you're telling me what to do. I want you to tell me why and what I did.
You're supposed to turn the negative to a positive.
You're telling me what I should do. I want you to tell me why what I did will not. I mean, this can't be true. Brandon?
So 4 minus negative 7 can't be 11. And
okay, so 4 minus 7 is not 11.
No.
Okay.
And if you take negative 1 plus 1 equals 9, it's turned to a positive on the other. So if you turn it into a positive,
Kelly. All right, Kelly. Tell me why subtracting 7 on this side, like what would I have to do if I subtract 7 from this side?
No.
What would I have to do if I subtract 7 from this side? What would I have to do?
You have to change the negative.
If I subtract 7 from one side, then I also have to
subtract 7 from this side.
And then so let's see what happens.
And that's not zero.
What do I get on the left side?
0.
No.
X.
Let's all calm our brains down. Let's just like close our eyes for a second. Take a deep breath.
14.
Now let's look at the problem again. Now what I'm asking you is, what's negative 7 minus 7?
0.
Negative 14. So x doesn't equal 4, x minus 14 equals 4, but that's not what I want to know. I don't want to know what x minus 14 equals. Okay, so I know that can't be right. I was going too fast. I was jumping the gun. I was not very careful there. But let's just start here. X minus 14 equals 4. Now, this is still true. It's as true as this was. We kept it balanced by doing the same thing to both sides. So how do we solve this equation the way it looks right now? Hunter? Add 14 to both sides. Now let's see if that's a good idea by looking at this side. Really looking at this side, seeing what happens. Stop thinking in terms of steps that you take and start thinking in terms of a strategy of getting x by itself. Now what is negative 14 plus 14?
Zero.
Equals 18. Is x plus 0, is that a good thing?
Yeah.
If I don't know what x is, x plus 0 is just x. So I don't even really need to pay attention to that, right? X is 18?
Yeah.
If we had added 7 from the beginning, would we have x as 18?
Yes.
Either way.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
So is that the way that we're going to do it?
No, I would not suggest that you subtract 7 and then add 14.
Okay.
I would suggest from the very beginning that you add 7 to both sides. But subtracting 7 from both sides, especially after just doing a problem like this, it's a common thing to try. I want you to think about what you're doing. I don't want you to think about, I want to get done with this problem. I remember I subtracted 7. That's probably what I subtracted 9 here, so I'll probably subtract 7 on this problem. Slow down. Slow, smooth. Right? Don't make mistakes. Right? If you don't make mistakes, it'll be faster in the long run. And if that takes you a little bit longer to make sure that each step you're doing something that's correct, then slow down and make sure that you're not making those small mistakes.
Were you adding those or subtracting the 7?
Well, in this case, I was subtracting 7. And negative 7 minus 7 is negative 14.
Oh, okay.
And then I realized, like, that's not. Who are talking? Stop talking. Especially when your peers tell you they're frustrated at your talking. What I'm trying to point out is to the person who tried subtracting 7 from both sides, they didn't slow down and think, what is it? What do I get when I subtract 7 from negative 7? I actually get negative 14, when what I was trying to get was 0. And then I come along and say, well, we can fix that. We can add 14 to both sides, and we'll still get the right answer. X is 18. If we add 7 from the beginning to both sides, X is 18. Let's try y minus 2.5 equals 9.6. All right, so we have an unknown quantity. Minus 2.5 is 9.6, right? So we can start to at least understand some things about y. Like y, it's got to be bigger than 9.6, right? Because I subtract 2.5 from it, and I get down to 9.6. So I'm expecting a number that's bigger than 9.6. The algebra part of it, okay, which we're dipping into that algebra well right now. The algebra part of it is to deconstruct the sign with y on it so that we have just y plus nothing else. So how do I get it so that it's y plus nothing else on this side? Two usuals here, three usuals, four usuals. Kelly?
Okay.
So we're trying to get plus 0 on this side, right?
Yeah, you want to do plus 2.5 and do it the same to the other side.
Okay, why add 2.5?
To even it out to 0. And then
to 0, right.
Yeah. And then, yeah, which equals 11.1, or 11.11, but then we'll simplify it to 12.1.
It is 12.1. So when you add 6 and 5, you get 11, but that's 11/10. Right?
Yeah.
And 11/10 is enough to make 1, and 1 more/10. So that's where we carry over to the ones place. What's that?
12.1
minus 5.2.
Hey! Minus 5.2.
That's where we borrow.
Oh yeah, okay.
So I want to take 5 tenths away from 1 tenth, but
okay, never mind.
Yeah, so we make that 5, make this 10, and that's going to be 5.
Because I got 11 points. I see what it is.
Am I even yeah, that's what, oh, this is this should be 11, not 10. Also,
it's good for you.
That's 11, and then so that'll be
10. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So this is what we call a one-step equation, where we're adding or subtracting to get zero and the least variable by itself. Kelly, what did I just say?
I know.
What kind of equation are these?
I don't know.
Okay, then maybe stop talking. Always be paying attention. James?
Single
step, one step, yeah. It's how many steps is it? And the kind of step is adding or subtracting. Okay, trying to get zero there. So on the one-step equations with adding and subtracting, you're gonna get a thumbs up or a thumbs down. Your thumb sideways. Show me how you feel about it. You know, are you ready to go to the next thing?
Yeah.
All right.
Well, we have 5 minutes.
All right.
Okay.
Now, look, we don't have much time, but that's at least, well, a lot your fault because you're doing a lot of talking when I'm trying to talk. Please stop. So this is a warning, okay? As we try to solve these equations, resist the urge to say, this is easy. I know exactly what x would have to be, okay? Like if I show you x minus 7 equals 11, and you say, well, okay, so x would have to be 18, so we're going to subtract 7, I get 11. I mean, that's good understanding, but that's not really a strategy for solving equations. The strategy is, let's get x plus 0. In this case, let's get x plus 0. Let's add 7 to both sides. Even though it seems like a silly step to take when you can easily see that x has to be 18, I want you to get in the habit of doing that, because when this equation comes along, you're trying to solve that. I was nice on this one. You can guess what the solution is, but if I make it this, okay. If I write this equation, you're not going to be able to guess what x is.
Okay. Oh my god.
There's actually two values of x that solve this equation. They're both negative. You could guess them. They're not that difficult. But this one, honestly, I'm not even sure if there are any solutions to that equation. And if there are two of them and probably decimals. Not going to be guessing those. Get out of the habit of guessing or just saying, oh, that's easy, I see what the answer is. Alright? So let's see how we do with the next kind of equation. This one right here. 3x, 7. I want you to do this step, okay? Even though it's easy to see what it would have to be, let's form good habits, okay? A good analogy is like in sports, where it might be easy when you're just at practice to do something sloppy and not great to get the job done. You want to practice those mechanics, right? Like throwing a ball. You might be able to throw a ball for me to Brandon, no problem. But I need to practice good mechanics to be able to throw it, you know, all the way from the outfield to my cutoff. Because
baseball players break their fucking
bat. No, really. Softball sometimes.